Since when do Democrats attack one another on universal health care?
Senator Sanders wants to dismantle Obamacare.
This is wrong, and every Democrat should be outraged.
Dismantle the CHIP program.
Enough with the speeches and the big rallies and then using tactics that are right out of Karl Rove's playbook.
Dismantle Medicare.
It is not only wrong, but it is undermining core Democratic principles.
Senator Sanders wants to dismantle Obamacare. Dismantle the CHIP program. Dismantle Medicare.
Shame on you.
Well, that is an American Crossroads ad put out today and deals with, obviously, Hillary Clinton back in 2008 and Chelsea Clinton on the campaign trail for her mother in 2016. We're back with the panel as we look at some the latest polls here. CBS, New York Times, nationally. This race has completely changed. Hillary Clinton was up 20 points in December, now only 7, almost within the margin of error there. Quinnipiac out yesterday in Iowa. Sanders now up 5, and this is, again, a switch. And then the Real Clear Politics average of the latest polls in New Hampshire has Sanders up 6, a little bit more than 6. Back with the panel. Julie, this race changed.
It did. I mean, we always talk about how we don't want to look at a poll in isolation, but when you look at these polls taken together, there's certainly a trend there where Sanders in both the early voting states, but also nationally, is either leading Hillary Clinton or is creeping up on her. And he likes to say on the campaign trail, and I think this is a very true statement, that in the Democratic race, there is one campaign that has enthusiasm, energy, and momentum behind it, and that is the Sanders campaign. Even if Hillary Clinton goes on to be the Democratic nominee, and I think it is still likely that she will be, the energy is elsewhere. It's not with her at this point.
Both in crowds, as we see on the Republican side with Donald Trump, but also in, as you say, grassroots, moveon.org and others. Here's what Hillary Clinton said about the state of the race.
I always expected that this would be a tight race. That's the experience that I've had, certainly, in politics. And I'm very happy about where my campaign is, what we're talking about, the reaction we're getting. It's going to be a campaign that goes right to the wire.
Here's the real problem, though, George. In every poll that asks this question about honest and trustworthy, it is completely upside down. Fox News, honest and trustworthy, Hillary Clinton, yes, 36%, no, 62%. Quinnipiac, released yesterday, honest and trustworthy question, and there you see compared to Bernie Sanders, honest and trustworthy, 93% to 3%.
First, it's unclear what you do when you're upside down on honest and trustworthy. If people don't like your agriculture policy, you change your agriculture policy. I don't know what you do about this. The reverse of not honest and trustworthy is sort of authenticity, and that's what Bernie Sanders brings to this. And that's why he's getting the energy. He is much stronger today, much more apt to be nominated than George McGovern was in January 1972 when he was at 3% in the polls and Ed Muskie, Senator Ed Muskie of Maine, was the prohibitive favorite to be nominated. In June, it was all over and McGovern was the nominee.
I talked to one Democratic operative who said if Bernie Sanders came out alongside Elizabeth Warren and said that they were going to run as a ticket together, that they might run the table in this environment.
I think that's possible because she's a plausible national candidate. I still don't think that Sanders is. I think there is a lot of enthusiasm. When Hillary says, you know, I always expect it will be a tight race, in a one-on-one with a 74-year-old socialist who honeymooned in the Soviet Union, and as Lindsey Graham said, never returned, it's a little bit hard to believe. George asked, you know, what do you do if your numbers on honesty are, you know, 60 against 30, 2-to-1 upside down? Well, the answer is try the truth. The problem is, you know, this is now 30 years late on that. So there's no way she's going to reverse that. But Sanders is not the threat. Once they go south, I think he has zero chance. It will make it interesting. We'll have a lot of storylines about New Hampshire, Iowa, but there's no, I can't see a path. What can happen, the person who will decide the nomination on the Democratic side is the FBI Director Comey. If he decides to do a criminal referral, I think she can collapse. Either it's quashed and then there's a huge scandal, or there is an indictment, in which case Biden steps forward and he offers himself self-sacrificially.
But you're saying even short of the DOJ moving forward with that recommendation, even if we learn that it happened?
If it happens and then it's squashed, so it doesn't actually go forward, I can imagine the career lawyers in the FBI, the career people, are going to resign en masse. It will be like the Saturday night massacre.
Very quickly, Julie, Bloomberg in Iowa, the Republican side, Ted Cruz up 3 within the margin of error, essentially tied with Donald Trump. And as you look at the RCP average of recent polls, it trends roughly the same. It's about tied. That the big matchup tomorrow night?
Yeah, I think you're going to see sort of all these candidates on one stage, but two distinct races happening there. You're going to have the Cruz and Trump race, which has become very heated after months of some relative civility among those two men. And then you're going to have the fight to be the establishment favorite. Right now, Rubio has a slight advantage, and you've seen everyone else go after him. So two races, one stage.
It will be fun to watch. We will talk about it tomorrow.